Today we want to see reception of vestigial sideband and signals. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of this session, student will be able to explain the concept of vestigial sideband reception. The contents of these topics are introduction, transmission efficiency, and complete channel bandwidth. Now, recall what is the means of SSB. SSB means transmission of signals with the help of single sideband. An SSB signal with carrier cannot be demodulated by an envelope detector to produce effective multiplication of the carrier with the sideband. There are two types of A for transmission, that synchronous demodulation and a square law device. Envelope detection can be used in television receivers. If the sideband amplitude is small as compared to the carrier, the envelope of the SSB with carrier signal equal to the modulating signal. If the picture carrier were successively modulated equal to depth by a series of frequency throughout the video frequency range employed by the system. Now, figure 1 shows intermediate frequency, that is IF receiver response curve. This figure relative video detector output voltage versus frequency in megahertz. Now, if you observe this frequency, the vestigial sideband is of a 2 voltage is up to 0.75 megahertz. When beyond the 0.75 megahertz, this vestigial sideband linearly reduced to 1 volt up to 1.25 megahertz. And after that 1.25 megahertz, it is a constantly up to 5 megahertz, it is a 1 volt. Means from 2 to 1 volt means at the frequency 0.75 megahertz to 1.25 megahertz, it will be reduced linearly. Now, if you observe the voltage present across 1.20 volt to 5 volt, it is a double. Across 0 to 0.75, the voltage is double as compared to the voltage across 1.25 megahertz to the 5 megahertz. Now, this figure 2 shows transmitted output characteristic for vestigial sideband signal. This figure is drawn relative transmitter output versus the frequency. Now here, this will shows of a total 7 megahertz, and P means is a picture carrier and S means sound carrier, and total effective bandwidth we use here 5 megahertz out of the 7 megahertz. And if you observe, this relative transmitted output will be linearly increased from 0 to some extent from frequency at the range 0 to 0.75. After that one, it will linearly to 5 megahertz. After that one, it will linearly reduce and it will be 0 again at the 5.5 megahertz. Now, this figure shows the desired receiver characteristics for correct reproduction of video signals. This figure drawn relative receiver output versus the frequency. Now, if you observe here, it will linearly increase up to 1 volt. After that, it will be the constant. Now, this vestigial sideband, can we prove how we say that this will be the linear? This will be linear. We said that mathematical equation, if A plus B is equal to 1 and A dash plus B dash equal to 1. Now, observe the 1 by 1. Now, if you observe the frequency at 0.5 megahertz, what is the relative output voltage? At the 0.5 megahertz, it will present at both the upper sideband. This will part is called as a upper sideband, means above the 0, it will called as a upper sideband, and below the 0, it will called as a lower sideband. Now, at the 0.5 voltage, the frequency is 0.2, that is the lower sideband, and the for the upper sideband, for the 0.5 megahertz, it will be the 0.8. when you add this 0.2 plus 0.8, it will become as 1. Therefore, 0.2 is a A and B is a 0.8, then it will become as a 1. Now, similarly, if we observe for the 0.7 megahertz, if you observe the 0.7 megahertz, for that 0.7 megahertz, it will present at the upper sideband as well as for the lower sideband. For the upper sideband, for the 0.7 megahertz, it will be the, if you observe, it will be the 0.92, and for the this A dash will be present at the 0.08. Now, if we add this 0.92 plus 0.08, it will become 1. Therefore, this condition will be satisfied. That is, a dash plus b dash equal to 1. Now, similarly, after that 0.5 and 0.7 megahertz, if you observe for the 0.75 megahertz, at that 0.75 megahertz, the lower sideband is 0, and upper sideband it will be represented as 0.75, it will be represented at 1. Therefore, lower sideband is 0, and upper sideband for the 0.75 megahertz, it will be the 1. Therefore, 0 plus 1, it becomes as a 1. Therefore, this characteristics A plus B for the vestigial sideband will be satisfied. Now, demerits of a vestigial sideband transmission. The transmitted power is wasted in the vestigial sideband filters. Second, a loss of about 6 decibel in the signal-to-noise voltage ratio. At the transmitter, phase and amplitude distortion of the picture signal occurs. It is very difficult to tune IF stage, means intermediate stage, intermediate frequency stage of the receiver to correspond exactly with the ideal desired response. Now, the main important thing is FM channel bandwidth, that is a frequency modulation channel bandwidth. The channel bandwidth required for the frequency modulation is, the formula is bandwidth is equal to 2 into N into FM. Now, N means, where FM means frequency of the modulating wave, N means number of the significant side frequency components, and the value of N is determined from the modulation index. The higher frequency in speech or music have much less amplitude as compared to the lower audio frequency. Now, the maximum frequency deviation is equal to 75 kHz and the modulating frequency is ranged between 25 Hz to 15 kHz. Now, for the frequency modulation bandwidth, we require two things. The first one thing is maximum frequency deviation and second thing is modulating frequency. And if we know these two things, and we can calculate easily the bandwidth. Now, we calculate the bandwidth. How we calculate the bandwidth? See, if a 15 kilohertz, we take an example, if a 15 kilohertz tone has a unit amplitude equal to the maximum allowed amplitude, then MF, modulation index of that frequency, is equal to 75 divided by 15, that is equal to 5. And for that 5, we calculate the value of Jn with the help of this Bessel function. From the Bessel function table, for the MF is equal to 5, the significant value of a Jn is equal to 7. Now, for this N is equal to 7, therefore, we put these all these values into the bandwidth equation, that is bandwidth equal to 2 into N into MF, that is 2 into 7 into 15, that become 210 kilohertz. Now, from that example, we conclude that bandwidth depends on, in the frequency modulation, that is depends on the tone amplitude, and in the amplitude modulation, the bandwidth depends on tone frequency. That's the two different parts. Now, take a similar example for the in the 625B television. If the maximum deviation, that is equal to plus or minus 50 kHz and modulating frequency equal to 15 kHz, then modulation index for that frequency carrier is equal to 15 by 15, that equal to 3. And from the Bessel function, if the value of for MF is equal to 3, then significant value of for that Jn is equal to 5. Now, put that values into the that bandwidth equation, then bandwidth equal to 2 into 5 into 15, that will become as a 150 kilohertz. Now, Carson's rule. Now, before going to the Carson's rule, what is the use for that one? See, Carson's rule is also used for the calculation for bandwidth. Now, whatever we calculate the bandwidth with the help of the previous that frequency modulation equation, that will give the exact value. But that we use the Bessel function. But here, without using the Bessel function, we can calculate the bandwidth. But with the help of this Carson's rule, that the bandwidth is near approximate. That Carson's rule. Now, what is that one Carson's rule? We see one by one. Carson's rule states that to a good approximation, the bandwidth requirement to pass an frequency modulation wave is equal to twice the sum of the deviation and the highest modulating frequency. Now, as already said that this Carson's rule is used for the bandwidth calculation. Now we calculate the bandwidth calculation, whichever we see in the example, the before two examples, we calculate the bandwidth equation with that formula, we calculate the bandwidth. Now, with the help of the Carson's rule, we can now calculate the bandwidth. The required bandwidth is equal to 2 into 75 plus 15, that becomes 180 kHz. And for the 625 line system, the required bandwidth is equal to 2 into 50 plus 15 is equal to 130 kHz. And now if you observe, that is a near approximate to the previous calculation. Now, this is the channel bandwidth for color transmission. Now, here, this is the total 7 megahertz channel is required. That is a video signal spectrum, and this is a color signal spectrum. Now, out of this video spectrum, it is a 7 megahertz, and out of this, the one 4.433 megahertz is required for video signal spectrum plus half of the color signal spectrum. And for the video signal spectrum and color spectrum and sound carrier and color and picture carrier require the 5.5 megahertz. Now, allocation of a frequency bands for television signal transmission. For effective amplitude modulation and better selectivity at an RF and IF tuned amplifier in the receiver, that is carrier frequency equal to 10 into highest modulating frequency. Now consider carrier frequency equal to 10 MHz, then highest video modulating frequency equal to 5 MHz, that deviation is equal to 50%. Now television standards. The picture and sound signal standards as specified by the International Radio Consultative Committee, that is CCIR, for the 625B monochrome system we want to see in the table. This is a table. Here number of lines for picture frame requires 625, field frequency that is 50, interlace ratio is 2:1, picture is required 25, picture frame frequency, line frequency is 15,625, aspect ratio 4:3, scanning sequence is left to right and field top to bottom. The references for this topic is as follows.